Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here and in this video we're discussing what is a surd. Now to start with, I'd like you to consider the numbers we've met so far in the section of Hegarty Maths, i.e. everything we've ever met in the number section up till now. Numbers like 17, whole numbers or integers. Numbers like a half, which are fractions. Numbers like 0.7, which are decimals. Terminating decimals, i.e. they end. Numbers like 0.7, recurring, that don't terminate and go on forever, but they repeat themselves. And numbers like 0.142857, that repeat every 142857. Now, all of these types of numbers are what's called rational numbers. Everything here is what's called a rational number. And a rational number basically means it can be written as a fraction. And anything that can be written as a fraction, there is something true about it, it will be either a whole number, an integer, i.e. a terminating decimal, okay, something like 0.7, terminating means it stops, or a recurring decimal. Okay, so let me show you how all of these can be written as a fraction. Any whole number can be written as 17 over 1. There you go, that's written as a fraction. A half, well, that's already in fraction form, 1 divided by 2. 0.7 is 7 tenths. So that's certainly a fraction. 0.7 recurring, if you remember the recurring decimals video, that was actually 7 ninths. And also 0.142857 recurring over itself was actually the fraction 1/7. And it was one I told you about, but I said you didn't necessarily have to remember. So you can see that all the numbers I've introduced to you so far can be written as fractions. So they are all rational numbers. And the implication of that is they are either a whole number, this one's a whole number, or they will be a terminating decimal, this one is 0.5, this one is 0.7, or they will be a recurring decimal. This one repeats, it goes on forever, but it repeats, so that's called recurring, and this one repeats as well. So they're all the numbers we've dealt with. But there are some other types of numbers out there as well, which this video is about. Now, just before we get onto that, we have to be able to state the first 15 squares and the first 10 cube numbers. Pause the video and check that you've remembered those. Well, the first 15 squares off the top of my head are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, 100, 121, 144, 169, 196. And 225. Now I really want you to be able to just know them as quick as I know them, if not quicker. And the first 10 cube numbers, 1 cubed is 1, 2 cubed is 8, 3 cubed is 27, 4 cubed is 64, 5 cubed is 125, 6 cubed is 216, 7 cubed is 343, 8 cubed is 512, 9 cubed is 729, and 10 cubed is 1000. I'd also really like you to know those, and that's going to help us going forward. So let's have a look at something with these. Now, given that these are square numbers, if I asked you what the square root of, let's say, 16 was, what would you say the answer is? Well, it is 4, isn't it? The square root of 16 must be 4. And what if I asked you what the square root of, let's say, 25 was? What would you tell me the answer was? 5, right? But what if I asked you, so imagine for the number, let's say, 20, what the square root of 20 was? Can you think of a number that squares up to 20? Well, it can't be 4 and it can't be 5, can it? And if we actually get our calculator out, watch this, and we're going to type square root 20 and press that, we get 4.472135955. And I promise you, that decimal will never stop, it will never terminate, and it will never start repeating itself either. And that is what we call a surd. Okay, so let me do another one with maybe the cube roots. Let's say the cube root of 27 we know is 3. and the cube root of 64 we know is 4. But if I asked you what the cube root of some number between those is, let's say, I don't know, 30, if we type that in the calculator, let's have a look, the cube root of 30, 3.10723250 6, it never terminates and it never starts recurring, and that again is called a surd. So let's formalize what a surd is. A surd is the answer to a root, square root, cube root, etc., which is an irrational number. And by irrational, I mean as a decimal form, it does not terminate and it does not form a recurring decimal. Now, irrational number is the first time we've met this type of number. Remember, all other numbers we've met could be written as a fraction, and irrational means can't be written as a fraction. Okay? And therefore, its decimal does not terminate, nor does it recur. Now, non-surds, examples of non-surds are really easy, like something like root 4 is not a surd because it is 2. And let's say something like root 9 is not a surd because it is 3. But root 5 in between 4 and 9 is a surd. If you type that in your calculator, let's have a check. You see, it's a decimal that goes on forever and never starts repeating. And another one, let's say something like root 7. Type that in. Again, we get another surd. So there are examples of surds. So just to recap, a surd is the answer to a root, a problem, a square root or a cube root, and it is what's called an irrational number. It can't be written as a fraction, and therefore, as a decimal, it never terminates, its decimal expansion never ends, and it never repeats itself either. And they're really special types of numbers. We'll meet others in future. Another one is actually pi, which we will meet in the geometry section. But for now, we've met a few: root 5, root 7, root 2 is another one. Right, let's try some questions on identifying. Which of the following is not a surd? It's easier to spot which one's not a surd. So, pause the video and tell me. Well, this one's not, because the square root of 100 is the whole number 10. This one's not, because the cube root of 1,000 is also 10. 10 times 10 times 10 is 1,000. This one's not, because the cube root of 125 is 5. This one's not, because the square root of 49 is 7. But it actually turns out this one is. 73 is not a square number, and if we type in our calculator square root 73, you see, it goes on forever. The one below it as well, we've already talked about square root 5. That again must be a surd. Now, what other ones aren't surds? Well, this isn't, because the square root of 81 is 9, a whole number. This one isn't, because the cube root of 216 is actually 6. This one isn't, because the cube root of 729 is actually equal to 9. This one we've already talked about is, but I would like to point out, if the square root of 2 is a surd, then 2 times the square root of 2, for example, is a surd as well, or 3 times or 4 times. So that's something I'd like to point out. The square root of 64 is 8, that's not a surd, but the square root of 2 is a surd. So here are our surds from this particular one: surd, 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 and 2 times a surd, well, that's also a surd. So there you go, that's how for us to identify what's not a surd and what is a surd. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.